Mr. Pasicha, what do you make of these theories that are floating around at this time that this could be the oil mafia at work? There's a lot of talk of how he was exposing the oil mafia, and the oil mafia could be behind this.
It was for publicity, as very rightly pointed out by this by the lady, that nobody will take a chance with a journalist of that reputation, because they know that the whole administration will go after them if they do so. So I don't think that could be the reason, but I won't like to conjecture also. But and instead of discussing only Daud or Chota Raja, it could be also somebody else, because as you rightly say, there's oil mafia. There could be also, because with the weakening of Daud and Chota Raja in the recent years, and a lot of young and unemployed youth have also formed their network. So they may be, they could also be there. Even sometime, Daud and Chota Raja or other big, you know, gangsters, they outsource to the, the killing to some new people, so that the police find very difficult to locate them for want of history. Well, all those things are possible, and I personally feel we'll have to wait for another 3-4 days when, although the police is working on various tracks, the thing will start coming out, and then we'll be able to really come out with logic what must have been the reasons behind.
But there was something very big that has been conclusively established. There was something very major which Jyotirmay Day knew about and others didn't want should get revealed to the outside world, which is why he was attacked. Otherwise, the underworld usually doesn't attack the media. I want to put, therefore, the second question that we're debating on the show this evening. Are underworld dons now back to haunt Mumbai? And I put this question first to Mr. Pasricha, who wants to come in. You know, we saw with Dawood Ibrahim's brother the attack that happened recently, and now this. Over the last few weeks, there have been several incidents which would point to the underworld emerging on Mumbai streets once again. They'd gone in hiding, as it were, you know, not doing any major hits on the streets. That started happening again. What do you make of this, Mr. Pasricha?
Well, this situation had reached the nadir sometime in 97-98. But thereafter, concerted action was taken and the gangsters were on the run. Then there was a lull for a long time. And unfortunately, in the last about few months, maybe about a year or so, they are again trying to, you know, flex their muscles, and is throwing a big challenge to the police, and will have to keep vigilant, because as I earlier said, that the possibility of young network behind the whole thing can also not be ruled out. It could be oil mafia, it could be Dao Chotrajan type or some other people. But that will be known only when the investigation.
Mr. Jethmalani, what do you make of the fact that the underworld is back with a bang and there's blood on Bombay streets once again?
I don't think that the underworld ever left Bombay. I mean, if you read the India Today story on the empire, for instance, of Daud Ibrahim, you will understand that it has been steadily growing. It's just that, you know, there's no need for any killings, because probably you're getting the patronage which you never had before. The most important thing, I think, to expose all these. Look, underworld cannot thrive in any city without political, police and bureaucratic support. And in as far back as in 1996, I think it was, you had the Vora Committee report, which went into the political criminal nexus. And they came out with a report. And unfortunately, in spite of a challenge in the Supreme Court, while the report was laid in Parliament, the annexures of the report, which exposed many politicians and people in high places, exposed with the mafia, that was not allowed to be revealed. I believe it was Justice Emery's judgment. Why it was never allowed to be revealed, I'll never understand, but it said that the individuals named in the annexures to the Vora Committee report will be harmed. Now, that should not have really been a consideration, because the Vora Committee report relied upon various nodal agencies. It relied on the IB, it relied on RAW to establish the fact that there was a police mafia politician nexus, and it named individuals. I think it's time now that, you know, in case those people are still alive, I'm talking about 97, in case those people with mafia connections are still alive and giving support to mafia people, their name should be exposed. It's time we all ask for the name of the Vora Commission to be made public.